continue to protest in large numbers? Could this unravel yet again?
Well, I think, as I said, we've addressed the problems and the concerns that people expressed very legitimately. And last night in the Dáil, I commended those many people who did lodge their protest in a way that was peaceful and that was very democratic and very heartfelt, I have to say. And the issues that they mentioned were dealing with PPS numbers, with the uncertainty about the charges, with the question of ownership of Irish Water, with the key issue of accountability, that people will know that their contributions are going for investment in the infrastructure. And we've addressed those very fully and comprehensively. And I do think that the selection process, which was followed in the Constitution Convention, in now setting up the People's Forum with 60 people from all over the country by gender and region and by age, will see a real engagement of the people, of the citizens who are registered with Irish Water, engaging with them about the programme for capital investment so that we know exactly what's happening. People can be happy that their money is being spent where it should be spent.
Can you rule out the possibility of further reductions if widespread protests continue?
No, the Minister Kelly's made it perfectly clear this morning. Government have responded now to the issues that were involved. And as I said, the return in income tax reductions starting in January will far outweigh the charge of €1.15 per week for a single person and €3 per week for two or more adults in a house. And it's also important to note that the Minister will legislate before the end of the year in respect of what happens in 2019. And irrespective of who is in government in 2019 or whoever the Minister for the Environment is in 2019, he or she will have the legal authority to continue capping water charges so that water continues to remain affordable.